So hi, welcome Christina to our show Java on Azure. I'm very happy to have you with us because you're the PM of App Service, which is a service that many Java developers are using. And we have some great news for everybody using App Service, including Java developers, which is the new App Service Environment V3. And of course, I have a few questions for you, but I will let you introduce yourself and introduce the service.
Sure. Thank you, Julien. My name is Christina Compy. I'm a program manager in the Azure App Service team, and I'm very happy to be here today to talk about the App Service Environment V3. The App Service Environment V3 is something that we've been working on for a few years. If you're familiar with the App Service Environment V2 or V1, both of them are single-tenant installs of the Azure App Service that allows you to host network isolated workloads in your own Azure virtual network. The V3 version's got a number of improvements that I'm really excited to talk about.
All right. And so it's mainly regarding the network access. So instead of having outbound traffic, now everything is inside your virtual network. Is that correct?
Well, before you used to have outbound dependencies and even inbound dependencies for your app service environment. But with V3, there are no dependencies, be it inbound or outbound, that are inside your Azure virtual network. This makes it a lot easier to secure, to pass security reviews, compliance, etc., where people can just take a quick look at the system and realize that it's as isolated as, say, a virtual machine running inside your virtual network.
Okay, so if I'm a big company and I want, I have strict compliance and security requirements, this is going to be much better for me.
Oh yes, this is definitely going to be much better. I mean, you have the benefit of it being a single tenant system. You also have the benefit of it being completely network isolated, and the added thing there is that it's isolated inside your Azure virtual network. It's all under your control. If you want to put up network security groups to secure the entire thing, you can. If you want to route the outbound traffic through your own firewall device, you can. Basically, the network is totally under your control.
I see there's a bullet point about stamp fee reduces. So there's, it's going to cost me less money. Why is that?
Yes. So the ACE V2 and V1 were, we'll call them, slightly expensive. And with ACE V3, we made a number of changes to the system architecture, and the system no longer costs as much as it did with V2 and V1. And that's allowed us to pass those savings onto our customers. So customers used to have to pay what we call a stamp fee with the ACE V2, and that stamp fee is gone in ACE V3. So that's a huge win in terms of upfront costs. So your pricing now is basically whatever you're paying for your app service plan. And if your ACE is completely empty, then you pay the fee as if you had one instance of the smallest app service plan. So it's pretty good.
Okay. It's not in the slide, but I heard also that it would be better for my performance, that there was some limit, I'm a Java developer. I used to do some performance testing with Cosmos DB, and I was opening lots of connections, and I was hitting some limits with V2. And if I understand correctly, this is also going to remove some limits.
Well, ACE V3 is built on top of DB4 hardware. So instead of in ACE V2, we had 1-core, 2-core, 4-core hosts that went with 3.5 gig, 7 gig, and 14 gig of RAM. Now we've got 2-core, 4-core, 8-core hosts, which have 8 gig, 16 gig, and 28 gig of RAM. So you can have larger workloads running inside your system. You have more cores available. Overall, the system is just more powerful.
Okay, and I will be also able to have more network connections from my app service to my external databases?
Well, that one, you're thinking of more like the SNAT outbound port problem. If you want, you can totally couple your system with a managed NAT, and you can avoid those problems. You can also use service endpoints or private endpoints for your databases, which I highly encourage you to do that from a security standpoint, but the ACE by itself isn't targeting the outbound snap port problem. It's more of, because the entire thing is running in your network, you can do whatever you like. You can add NAT gateways to it or firewall devices, etc., to provide additional security to your system.
Okay, yeah. Well, that's another video we'll need to do about securing your database access, because it's a little bit more advanced. Okay, do you have anything else to show us on ACE v3?
Well, I guess I can highlight a couple of the other things that come with ACE v3. One of the things that's important to call out is the last item in this list, which is that there will be an upgrade available. So when we get near GA or shortly thereafter, we will have an upgrade from ACE v2 to ACE v3. This is a big deal because we didn't have that going from V1 to V2, and that was a problem for many customers. So going from V2 to V3 will be something that's programmatically possible. You will also have the ability to deploy it on dedicated hardware. So if you're one of those folks who need everything to be yours, not just a single tenant system, but you want it all the way down into the metal, then you'll be able to deploy an ACE v3 on dedicated hardware too.
Okay, so I can even install that in my own data center.
No, it'll be still in the Azure data center, but yeah, it's deployed on top of Azure dedicated hosts or host groups under the covers. But essentially, you know, within the Azure data center, there's dedicated metal that belongs to your workloads.
Okay.
Want to make sure that customers can host their workloads on App Service as secure as they want and as feature-rich as possible.
Yeah, and so, Christina, concerning ACE v3 versus v2, so I understand that customers will be able to upgrade from one version to the other. They will have, like, I don't know, a button on the portal to upgrade. How will this work?
Yeah, we're going to have an upgrade capability shortly after GA, so customers can move from V2 to V3. But it's very important to call out why a customer would want to move from V2 to V3. So here's a quick comparison. One is that V2 is expensive. I mean, while we do appreciate, you know, people giving us money, I think a lot of customers would rather save a dollar or two. And so to that end, V3 is a lot cheaper than V2. In V2, you have all these networking dependencies, inbound and outbound, that you have to keep track of. In ACE v3, you have no inbound or outbound dependencies. You could put a network security group in that blocks all outbound traffic to the internet if you want. It won't hurt the ACE. In V2, you could never do such a thing. You have to allow the outbound traffic that the ACE depends on. And it's definitely complex. In ACE v2, scaling takes a variable amount of time. Not only does it take a long time, but it takes a varied amount of time. In V3, it still takes longer than we want, at least initially, though we're burning that down. We have plans to make that much faster, but at least in the preview to GA time period, the benefit is that it'll be reliably the same amount of time. And that Linux is much faster than it used to be. It's around 10 minutes right now to scale horizontally for our Linux workloads. And then, as far as the virtual machine families go, with ACE v2, we were statically locked to DB2 hardware. With ACE v3, we've been replatted onto VMSS, and we have a separate network. So our plan is, after GA, to be able to add additional VM families to the system and make it more flexible around supporting whatever customers need to host. So that's a quick rundown on the comparison. If I was to look at ACE v3, I'd say this is largely the future of Azure App Service. That, you know, when you get right down to it, customers are going to want security and isolation and single tenancy. And now that ACE v3 is pretty much in the same price point as the rest of Azure App Service, that looks very strong as a contender. I can't imagine most folks using anything else if they're worried at all about security.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, I came for security, but now I'm also learning that it's better for scalability, for performance, for price. So it's a, well, it's a lot of great new features that are arriving to App Service.
Yes.
By the way, we will need to have another talk on network security because you're the boss on this. And I know a lot of Java developers are very interested by network security between the apps and the database and other services. But that will be in another talk. So thanks a lot, Christina. Thank you for all the information. And sure. Talk to you soon for another video. Thank you.
Sure. Bye, Julien.
Bye. Thank you.